is backed by physical assets like gold, for example. When it comes to Bitcoin and all, there is a challenge to be backed with something tangible like gold. The current situation is pushing us as you know, as Sharia scholars, as you know, as structurer of this industry, to think and innovate a way to back this currency with an asset based. At this moment, it's a challenge that would lead us to get a very soon a solution for it, whether we're gonna see it in a very near in a future, or one way or another, we will find this solution for sure. I do remember a few years ago, there is a big challenge of trading gold, for example. Today, IOFI had provided standards to provide, to trade golds, for example, which was just a couple years ago, a big challenge for us. So it's a new era that had, opened for us. Similarly, the Bitcoin trend would face that challenge, and I'm pretty much sure that we will see a very near future with a very innovative idea. But I fully support one thing. In order to push the industry to get these innovative ideas, I'm going back to education.
Sure.
We need to provide the, the principle of this industry for our students, because they are the next generation to provide us all the solutions needed for the industry. Without developing a curriculum that provide the creativity for the next generation for this industry, it would be very challenging to find somebody coming with new ideas. Most of what we will be doing is mocking up what is in the conventional industry, and wrapping it with Islamic economy box, and that's not what we want to do. We want to derive from the principle of the Islamic religion new ideas, and I'll summarize it with one example. The biggest project that we are implementing today in Islamic finance is a project called Murabaha, which is being implemented heavily by the financial sector to the extent it's reaching up to 80% of their daily transactions and implementations in Islamic finance. Can you imagine that this project, considered to be only one sentence in the Islamic jurisprudence, that has been derived from, as a result, we got a product that is being implemented 80%, whether it's in a Muslim or non-Muslim countries. This shows you that the Islamic jurisprudence is so rich of innovative idea for Islamic economy, specifically for Islamic finance. And I personally, started searching about the structure that the Bitcoin, for example, or this encrypted currencies to be based on, whether to back it with the famous like gold, or to back it with a new asset based like real estate or things like this. So these are maybe we go back to the to educational sector and ask them to host these workshops, to host a lot of projects that would somehow bring the result of the new solution.
Большое спасибо, господин Аджанахи. Вы ответили на один из тех вопросов, который меня, честно говоря, мучил по криптовалютам. То есть получается, и в целом большое спасибо за комментарий по IT-инновационному банкингу. Получается, что криптовалюта, не обеспеченная активом, она не может быть полноценным, скажем так, продуктом, активом исламского финансирования. Правильно я вас понимаю?
I'm not getting that.
My question is, do you believe that cryptocurrency, in essence, is basically cannot be considered to be Sharia compliant?
If it's not assets backed,
that's a, you know, that's a rule of thumb. It has to be backed by
assets.
Yes. Yes.
That's why. Sure. Спасибо большое. На пространстве.